Here is the scene at Rio Centro Pavilion 3, day 11 of the 12-day program of table tennis at Rio 2016. It is the women's team gold medal match. The focus here to be decided whether China or Germany will go away with the gold medal. China, the overwhelming favourites for this team event for the women. Germany have already made history, the first European country to make the team final. China looking to win a third consecutive gold in the team event. And Don Parker, the Chinese have been dominant so far, taking the men's and women's singles of the table tennis here in Rio. And they're looking good in this one. Favourites coming in with such a strong team, and they've come through comfortably.
They have, and there we can see their route to the final. Each of those games was won 3-0. They're in great form. The whole world knows that they are the strong favourites to take the gold medal here. But of course, in sport, you can never 100% guarantee anything. But the big problem for Germany is it's not just like in the singles, you just need to win one match and you've beaten one of the Chinese. Here, you've got to win three matches. And that's going to be really tough, to be perfectly honest. If Germany can win one match against a team that includes the numbers 1, 2 and 5 in the world, then they've done really well. To take three matches would be almost unbelievable. But we'll keep our fingers crossed for Germany to put in a really good performance. They'll be doing amazingly well, as I say, to win a couple of matches.
So not dropping one on the way through to the final. A terrific run through for China and for Germany. They came through against the USA first up, Hong Kong, and then a nail-biter against Japan in their semi-final.
And I think nail-biter really is exactly what it was. It was two matches each. We started the fifth and final match, and it went down to the wire. It was won 11-9 by Han Ying on a disputed edge ball, millimetres in, deciding who actually won.
Here are the teams striding out onto the performance space here. China leading the way, top seeds for this competition, and they have to be one of the strongest sporting teams in the world. Introductions about to take place. China versus Germany. Li Xiaoxia, Liu Shiwen and Ding Ning, gold medalist in the singles. Han Ying, and there's Petrissa Solja, and Shan Xiaona. Big moment for all of these women, having made their way through to this gold medal match. And especially for Germany, after the excitement of making it through. The first European country to make the team final. And we already have the start list in terms of the singles in this team event. It starts with two singles, matches within the overall match, five matches, each the best of five 11-point games, two singles, then a doubles, and a further two singles as required. So the first match will be Han Ying of Germany up against Li Xiaoxia. And it's amazing, the wealth of talent that the Chinese team has to call upon. Number one in the world is Li Xiwen, and two former number ones, the gold medalist, the silver medalist. It's just unbelievable, really, the lineup of talent that they have.
They've been incredibly well managed over the years, and it's quite interesting. The last time China lost in a significant final was in 2010. They lost in the World Team Championships in Moscow to Singapore. And the Chinese coach at the time took a gamble and he played two youngsters in that team. And those two youngsters happened to be Ding Ning and Liu Shiwen. And Fung Tianwei won two for Singapore, and it was a real shock in the table tennis world. But it was a good example of the Chinese promoting the youngsters, and just look what the youngsters have done for them now. Liu Shiwen is ranked number one in the world, and Ding Ning's the world and Olympic champion. So I think there's a good message there to countries that are developing the players. You've got to give the youngsters a chance. They might not deliver first time. Persevere with them, and there's every chance they'll come and do the business for you. Li Xiaoxia, interesting that she's going out there and playing the first singles. She's 28 years old. She's the oldest player in the team. I guess this could be her last Olympic Games. The Chinese tend to turn the players round fairly quickly. She'll be conscious of that. She'll want to go out on a top note with a gold medal, so she'll be really fired up for this one.
She has said that this will most likely be her last outing representing her country. So a big moment for her. She wants to bring her best to the table. And she is up against Han Ying, 33 years of age, number 7 in the world. She's at her highest career ranking right now. And there'll be an interesting contrast in styles here with Han, a more defensive player.
Exactly. She's going to drop away from the table and use backspin. But on Han Ying's mind will be the fact that Li Xiaoxia is very good against backspin, so she also knows now she's going to have to be brave, she's going to have to attack when she gets the opportunity. So I think we'll see quite a bit of attacking from Han Ying, but you're absolutely spot on, she will drop away from the table and use backspin. It should be a very entertaining game. Number 7 in the world against number 5 in the world, so the rankings don't favour China that much on this particular game. The gentleman in the corner there, China do come up with some pretty impressive coaches. Kong Ling Hui, world champion, Olympic champion. And there we have G Shop, who was no mean player herself, European champion, played for Germany many, many times. So we've got two great players acting as the coach here. Everyone's a great player.
We'll sit here. Gold medal match in the women's teams event. China, Germany. We're talking about the rankings, though, and really, Li Xiaoxia's ranking of 5 is a little deceptive. She's a former world number 1 and the gold medalist from London.
Top spun the ball back there. Han Ying got the top of the net and the deviation in the trajectory of the ball. One of the point. Good start. She really came underneath that first backspin, fast accelerating racket, underneath the ball, fizzing with backspin.
And interesting already to see the positions around the table.
Didn't really control the heavy topspin there, popped the ball up and a great smash from Li Xiaoxia. This time a fast topspin down the line. So 4 points, 2 points each. It'll settle down fairly soon. Han Ying will be hoping to get into a rhythm, to return on a consistent basis the topspins from Li Xiaoxia. Li Xiaoxia, on the other hand, will be looking to break up that rhythm, not allow Han Ying to settle down.
That is brilliant, accelerating through that topspin forehand. That's the sort of pace she can produce.
Fast topspin, took it early, hit the top of the net, flipped it off the end of the table, 3 points each. It's quite interesting watching Li Xiaoxia's career when she was 3-4 years ago. They sort of had a nickname for her as the Eternal Second. She was a great player, but couldn't just win the big titles. Then, of course, London, she became the Olympic champion. 1 year later, she won the World Championship. So the two big titles came 2012-2013.
She's the fourth female to win the Grand Slam, the World Cup 2008, and the Olympic gold you mentioned in 2012. world champion in 2013, and that was singles and doubles. A brilliant run.
Heavy backspin. Interesting that Han Ying plays with two different types of rubber. The red side is a short, pimpled surface, good for imparting backspin, good for control. And the black side of her racket is the normal reverse, the smooth rubber, good for imparting spin, but a little bit more difficult to control the ball. So you see here, she's got the red rubber on the backhand, black rubber on the forehand, and she just loses control there with the reverse side of the racket.
Because Li Xiaoxia has not played any of the German players before. Whereas Han has a losing record against both of the other Chinese players.
Underneath the ball there again, fast accelerating wrist, and plots a lot of backspin. Really got to lift, you've got to come up the back of the ball, lift the backspin.
Is getting lured into playing Han's game. Started with some good aggressive topspin. German with the upper hand here, 2 points ahead.
A bit of good fortune. Good backhand defense. And Han Ying just catching the top of the net. You'll see it on this ball. There it goes. Flicks the top of the net. And the push into the net by Lee. So a really good start by Germany. She's playing rock solid. She's made no mistakes when she's been defending. She's returning the ball, varying the spin. Obviously, when you're varying the spin all the time, you're using your wrist, you're using different points of contact. It is more difficult. And you will make mistakes. She has to play positive. She has to defend in a positive way by varying the spin.
Great attack from Lee.
The line of play well there. Top spins into the back end, and suddenly, as we'll see on the replay, she whips one down the line. There it goes.
Oh, a couple of lucky breaks for her in this opening game.
Playing well, and as you say, she's having a few lucky breaks. Might just be enough to take this first game. 9-7, 2 points away.
Tense situation here with a huge point.
You took the words out of my mouth there. Big point, I was about to say.
9-8. And that is good aggression from Lee. She levels. This is anyone's game.
into the body, wide to the forehand. Kong Ling Hui applauds the tactics there, very clever. There's the one into the body, and then wide to the forehand. And Han Ying was actually going the wrong way. She thought it was going down the backhand. She tried to recover, but game point now for Li.
And she finishes it off, 11 points to 9. Li Xiaoxia takes the opening game.
Just have a look at that last point again. This is the one she hit straight down the line, no mistake there. Good effort by Han Ying, but the Chinese aren't just great players, they're actually very mentally tough as well.
Game. It was Han Ying who led most of the way. She had the edge, started very well. Li Xiaoxia coming back with some great aggression, some big topspin winners, playing tough when it counted.
So the players back at the table. Love all, second game. I just wonder now whether the machine has got going and it will now be relentless top spins.
That's the danger, isn't it, for Han? That is so fast.
On there, played with a little bit of topspin. It's a lot easier to take the ball early against topspin. That's exactly what Li Xiaoxia did on that occasion.
Good strike from Han.
Tactically, this is what she needs to do, take a few chances. She hits straight through that with the short pimple side of the racket. Good for hitting through spin.
Another huge forehand topspin from Li. I wonder whether she feels any more pressure, this being her last match, possibly, for China. So she wants to go out and accomplish the task for the team.
Just lifting what she thought was heavy backspin, wasn't quite the spin on the ball. She lifted the ball off the end of the table. I do think the Chinese have a really strong tradition for the team. I think the team is very important to them.
There's like a huge emphasis on that. Li was talking about the unity that the team has. You may beat one Chinese player, but you won't get through all of them, is pretty much the message that she was delivering.
Let 2-4.
Coach Hong also saying nothing can break our team. Very positive words.
Yeah!
read the spin really well there. Han Ying coming underneath the ball, fizzing with backspin. You can see it there, a little bit high, but nevertheless, the spin very well read by Li Xiaoxia. Remarkable touch there. 1 minute she's playing powerful shots and exploding, and then she returns that net cord with the most delicate of touch shots. See that again, just look there, how she touches that. Tremendous amount of skill, feeling, soft hands, all sorts of expression for that, but very talented.
Excellent play again, and she's got to be patient, wait for the right ball. 7-2, Li of China leading in this first of the matches in the team event.
Great smash straight down the line, total body action there. It starts with the legs, the upper body rotates. You see here, twist the body, complete rotation, shoulder, elbow, wrist, perfect technique, 8-2. Pinning her in the body, she's not sure whether to play backhands or forehands. Just sends here her 9-7 up, I think she was, in the first game. That was a big chance. And then she lost the next 4 points, and it's been downhill from thereafter.
Li Xiaoxia playing so confidently in this second game. Now, many opportunities to close this one out, this game. Han saves one.
She's brave. She attacked down the line with the backhand. I think that's all she can do in the next game. Throw caution to the wind. Attack a lot more. Take a few chances.
And there it is, the second game, going 11 points to 3. To Li Xiaoxia of China, she leads 2 games to love in this first of the matches in the team gold medal match. Gold medal match in the women's team event.
Germany to serve, low ball.
It's Li leading 2 games to love. Possibility of 5 matches. It is best of 5. 2 singles followed by a doubles, and then further singles as required. Good attack again. She is really on fire, so confident.
very interesting what she's doing. Sometimes she opens up with a fast forehand topspin. Sometimes she throws the ball up with a slower forehand topspin, a heavy spin. It's very difficult for Han Ying to settle down. And the German bench has realised that this is drifting away now. She's lost the first game, 11-9, then 11-3. And she's 2-0 down. And the momentum clearly very much with Li Xiaoxia. So Xi Shop, who is the German coach. How do you break the momentum? Let's have a 1 minute break, see what it does.
Smart strategy, calling the timeout.
Former European champion, the lady in red. And this lady in red, a former world and Olympic champion.
Silver medalist here in the singles, beaten by Ding Ning, her teammate. Can Han Ying do anything to change the course of action here? Down two games to love and two love. Top spin from Li. Into the body and then out wide. Super aggressive. 1-3.
I'm afraid it's looking very difficult now for Han Ying. Arguably she had a chance in that first game to get one game up, and then who knows, but now it just really does seem as though Li Xiaoxia in the driving seat. But what a wonderful block down the line there. Held the ground, decided not to drop away from the table in defense. She has to do something different. Held the ground, backhand punch down the line. Why not try something different? Attack when you get the chance. 50-50, take the chance, go for the attack. See there with the wrist, how she went under the ball, wrist into the action. So the bat is accelerating fast. The rubber bites into the ball then fizzes with backspin. Really good technique by Han Ying.
All three consecutive points going to Han Ying of Germany. Levels this third game. She was looking down and out, with Li really blasting the winners.
It's a lovely smash there. Deception with the upper body. Looked as though it was going in one direction, all of a sudden in the opposite direction. And what a good timeout. We had the timeout and the game has totally changed in terms of the momentum. In fact, the momentum now very much with Han Ying. She's taken 3-4 of the last 5 points. The net board there helping Li Xiaoxia. Sticks her hand up, acknowledges her good fortune. Most people wouldn't have missed that one, let alone Li Xiaoxia.
Li edges ahead again. Thank you. loses that one. And back level again in this third game. Very experienced Han, 33 years of age. At her career best ranking of number 7 in the world.
Heavy top spin from Li Xiaoxia, wide to Han Ying's forehand, quite controlled. Tried to steer it back with a little bit of top spin, which you see that on the replay. There it is. She tries to guide it back, keep it deep, just overhits it slightly. It was the right thing to do. She had to take on the smash. It was a little bit high, but it was deep. It was close to the baseline, which you see on the replay. It was almost right on the baseline. Always makes it more difficult for the person attacking.
Li closing in on victory here. Best of 5 games.
Again, you could see there the wrist just got under the ball. I think Li Xiaoxia's reading the spin, but there's actually more spin on the ball than she thinks. Table, a rocket into the backhand, a drop shot, and then a rocket out wide to the forehand. There's the drop shot, and this one wide to the forehand. There it goes.
Now Li stands at 2 points from taking this opening match.
Good placement into the body again. Han Ying just not knowing whether to play backhand or forehand, hesitated.
3 match points for Li of China. Xiaoxia of China takes the first match in this gold medal match, the women's team event. She was brilliant out there, really started well, played very confidently, taking that in straight games, 11-9, 11-3, 11-7. Celebration from her after taking this, very businesslike at the end after closing this one out. Knows there's a lot more to be done before you can take the gold medal. Team event best of 5 matches. That the first singles, and now we will have a second singles coming up. There's a result, 11-9, 11-3, 11-7 for Li Xiaoxia. And really a convincing victory for her. So China leading 1-0, and the second one to come out will be Liu Shiwen up against Petrissa Solja of Germany. Such a professional performance from Li, one of the great players of the game.
So there she is, Liu Shiwen, out at the table, waiting for her opponent. Must be a little bit frustrating for Liu Shiwen, number 1 in the world, and yet she's not given a chance in the singles. Ding Ning and Li Xiaoxia playing in the singles. Each country can only enter two players. However, she did have a few wobbles against Feng Tianwei, and I think that's what worries Hong Minghui a little bit. And he's not prepared to take the chance, and of course, they won the gold and the silver in the women's singles, so no one can argue with his decision. But I do feel a little bit sorry for Liu Shiwen, but she's now in a position to contribute significantly to China winning the gold medal.
Playing for the gold medal here, it's China up against Germany. And the second match in the team event, and it's Liu Shiwen of China against Petrissa Solja of Germany. Solja, number 15 in the world. She's only 22 years of age. A talented young player. And looking there at Liu Shiwen, the number one player in the world. 2016, this year, she's won the Japan Open, the Qatar Open, on the World Tour events. In double, she's won three titles. Silver medalist at the World Championships in 2015 also. Petrissa Solja, 2015 European champion in the German team. Hasn't played any of the Chinese players yet. So this is the first meeting.
Solja was unbeaten in the match against Japan, the 3-2 victory in the semi-final, a massive contribution that she made, which for a 22-year-old, a really good performance. Very talented, left-handed, which some players can have a problem with a left-hander, but there are quite a few left-handed players on the circuit, so it's not quite as unusual as some people would expect. But she's certainly talented, good wrist.
Second match of the gold medal match. Solja of Germany, Liu of China.
Good backspin on the service, coming underneath the ball. Very loose grip when she serves. That just relaxes the wrist a little bit. If you hold the back tight, the wrist locks.
It has been difficult for Liu Shiwen, sitting on the sidelines during the singles events, now itching to contribute to China's campaign here.
So he was lifting the ball a little bit too much. Thought there was backspin on the ball. There wasn't. She lifted. And of course, the ball then goes off. Good deception on the serve. German bench happy with that point, 3 points each. Fast serve down the line, she came across the ball, put side spin on it, and it was the side spin that took the ball off the sideline. World champions, two Olympic champions. Pretty impressive bench, China.
It's a good brains trust, isn't it?
Playing strong into the body of Solja. And he's looking quite relaxed there, smile on his face.
So much planning and preparation goes into these campaigns. and his team. Great preparation, do their homework on all of the opponents. On stage they felt they might be playing Japan in this final.
They actually travel with a large entourage, with the sports science, with the doctors and the physios, but even with practice partners. So they'll have a defensive player from China in the squad who's there to give their players practice against defence. So Li Xiaoxia has just played a defensive player. She'll have been practicing for a few hours yesterday against defence.
Three, nine.
No stone left unturned.
Well, reaped so much success. China looking to win a third consecutive gold in the team event. Game points for Liu Shiwen. And she takes the opening game convincingly, 11 points to 3. Again, it just strikes you what a business-like performance it is out there. Not allowing Petrissa Solja to get into it too much.
I think Liu Shiwen is the fastest player in the world. When two players are close to the table playing at speed, I think she's the best in the world. Quite as good at generating spin with big forehand top spins as perhaps Ding Ning or Li Xiaoxia. But speed, she's the number one.
Point on serve in that opening game. Liu, a tremendous performance from her. Liu Shiwen leading one game to love. Second singles match. The team event, the best of five potential matches. Two singles and a doubles. And then two more singles if required.
Super play there by the German player. Very quick with the forehand and the backhand, and a good angle on that backhand out wide to Liu Shiwen's forehand. Well played, Solja. So tight over the net, we've seen so many let serves. Good tactics by Solja there. She's determined to get in with a strong topspin behind her serve. The return there was very close to the sideline. Solja wasn't sure whether she could play away from the table or whether she'd have to play over the table. Good table tennis, both players.
Things after going down those opening two games. They're directing that ball well.
A long fast serve down the line. Solja read it well, as we see on the replay. Picks it up with that backhand topspin. Again, unlucky Solja. Good tactics. She's having a go. She's not just blocking the ball back. But if you do, you rely on your opponent to make a mistake. Liu Shiwen's not going to make mistakes, or very, very few. You've got to force the ball. And that's what Solja was trying to do. Elbow wrist, took the ball early, got over the top of the ball. Just not quite enough. Certainly the right approach from the German player. Taking on the master of speed. They don't come much quicker over the table than Liu Shiwen.
Oh, that is so sharp. Really taking on Liu Shiwen here, 4-all.
Again, a good return from Solja. The second bounce was on her around the baseline. She gambled, it's coming long. She went in with the topspin. There's that forehand topspin. She's now in the rally. She's given herself a chance. Just missed times that forehand topspin. Well played. She's showing us why she's number 15 in the world, is Solja here. She's playing some great shots. The halfway stage in the second game, she's held her own. 5 points each.
Five, six. Oh, what a time. And Solja was just in a role, playing very well. Fortune favouring you.
Over hitting the backhand topspin, but again, it was good to see her trying to take the initiative. If I was the coach, I'd be quite happy with the way she's playing. And it looks as though we've had a timeout called. G-Shot just calling Solja over. Maybe 5-all. This is the one she has to win. I'm sure G-Shot's thinking this is the one she has to win if she's going to have any chance of winning the match. She goes 2-0 down. Then, and you're against the number one player in the world, then whilst it's not all over, it's a big mountain to climb. If she can just win this second game, who knows, she's got a chance. So it was drifting away, momentum was with Liu Shiwen. G-Shot calls timeout. I think it was a good call. Coach who calls the timeout, although there could be an agreement with the player, but it's the coach who has the right to call the timeout. In the individual event, it's the player who has the right to call the timeout.
Let's see if the timeout helps the cause of Petrissa Solja. She's behind, and is set. 2-point deficit in the second game.
She left off. Very good forehand topspin. Took it early.
Five, nine. It hasn't helped the cause so far. And now you only 2 points from taking this second game.
Since the timeout, she's not won a point.
Game points for China. And there it is, the second game going to Liu Shiwen. 11 points to 5. She extends her lead to 2 games to love. Yes, the timeout had almost the opposite effect on Petrissa Solja. But it was a good strategy. It was the right time, because now that she's down two games to love, it is a big road back against the world number one, Liu Shiwen.
The coach is trying to identify a pivotal moment, and I think she shot me right there. To have any chance of winning the match, she had to win this second game. You know, fingers crossed she can come back and do well in the third game, but against the number one in the world, it's tough.
Well, the middle stages of that second game, she was right in it, playing some very smart, aggressive table tennis. Sensational play from Liu Shiwen to seal that game. Really put the foot down in the latter stages. And Solja just dropping off with her game. So we are in a situation where Liu Shiwen leads two games to love. Third game.
Accelerating at some pace there over the net, and it was Solja who came out on top. A lot of topspin, fair bit of pace, but it's the variation that makes life difficult for Solja. Heavy backspin on the service there, the loose grip on the racket for the service action. Accelerating the wrist, maximum speed of the racket, brushing the ball. Clenched fist, punch in the air there. Liu Shiwen means everything to her.
All of the Chinese players just have such great intensity levels in the way they play and sustain their level of play throughout the matches. Established a two-point buffer now in this third game, 4-2.
Service, Solja not quite lifting sufficiently.
Three, five.
Important point for Solja. Liu Shiwen had just won five consecutive points. She needed to break that run, try and get a little momentum going herself. She's got her two serves. Can she get in behind the serve? Good push into her body. She didn't quite get into position to make the backhand topspin, the German player.
And time running out here for Petrissa Solja. The third game getting away from her. Yep, leading 7-3.
Edge. The ball came back so fast, she didn't quite time her topspin. It hit the leading edge of the bat, as you see on the replay. Flies off the end of the table. She was 2-0 up in this game. She's now 8-3 down. Eight of the last 9 points for China. And a soft block there. She took the pace off the ball. There you can see how she just held back slightly. Ball dropping short of Liu Shiwen.
Oh, brilliant, just so quick. Boy, she gets onto those 2 points from victory here. Great placement, both sides of the table. Match points for Liu Shiwen of China. She's got 6 of them. And there it is, 11 points to 4. Liu Shiwen winning that in straight games, sealing the third, 11-4. What a terrific performance from her. China leading 2-0 in the overall match.
Very impressive from the two Chinese players. We now have a 5-minute break, during which time the coaches will decide which one of the two players that we've already seen will play in the doubles. We know that Ding Ning has to play in the doubles. She's the third Chinese player in the team. And we know that Shan Xiaona will play in the doubles as well. What we don't know is who their partners will be. We'll shortly find out. I'll be very surprised if we don't see Ding Ning playing with Liu Shiwen. They've played the 3 games so far. They're the regular pairing that China put out in all the open tournaments. And again, I'll be surprised if we don't see Solja coming out and playing in the doubles again. Interesting, Germany had 2 incredibly tough matches. In the quarterfinal, they beat Hong Kong 3-1, but it was a really tight game. And then they had the epic battle against Japan, 3-2. And it just seems as though they've not really got it going here, have they?
No, China have been overwhelming so far with those straight game victories in the opening 2 matches, the singles. And have a 2-to-love lead. Solja gave that her all. She tried to find a way to get through Li Xiwen, but she was just too tough, Liu. Too consistent. Couldn't sustain the attack she needed.
You mentioned earlier in commentary that this is the first time a European team has got through to a medal position. So it's a fantastic performance by Germany. And indeed, if you look back since table tennis became an Olympic sport in 1988, there's only been one other medal by European ladies. The women's doubles back in 1988, Faslik and Kukucin for what was then Yugoslavia. So it's an amazing performance by Germany, we mustn't forget that. But they're just up against one of the best teams that this planet's ever seen.
And you're not talking just table tennis either, they are one of the great sporting teams when you look at the lineup that China have. This is how it stands in the women's team gold medal match. China leading 2-love. Over Germany. Liu Xiaoxia and Liu Shiwen winning their singles matches, both 3-to-love.
And we just saw confirmation on screen there that the doubles is exactly as we predicted. Ding Ning will be playing with Liu Shiwen, and Solja will be coming out. Tough one for Germany.
Well, they're in a tough situation here, Germany. And there is Shan Xiaona, who will join Petrissa Solja. They're getting out on the table pretty quickly here, not mucking around.
Been pretty quick. I don't think anybody's exhausted at the moment. We haven't had any 5-game thrillers yet. I'm getting my games and my matches mixed up. We haven't had any 5-game thrillers yet.
So the team event, the best of 5 matches, already played two, the opening two singles matches, with China winning both of those. Now it is time for the doubles. With victory here, China can clinch the gold medal. Germany must win this doubles to stay alive in the gold medal match. Solja has to put the disappointment of that singles behind her, come out and really be positive in this doubles inside Shan Xiaona. Ding Ning, the singles gold medalist here, taking to the court. Toss. Melodies in the way before this doubles gets going.
Of course, in doubles, whatever the order is in the first game, it's alternate hitting of the ball, and then you change the order for the second game, and the third game you go back to the original order. So sometimes you can have a preferential order, one that suits you better. Of course, with slightly contrasting styles here, Shan plays with short pimples. She's a penhold grip player, hits through the ball very flat. And we have Petrissa Solja, who spins the ball. So slightly different styles and techniques on the German side of the table.
Ding Ning, a left-hander, combining with Liu Shiwen. And here are the Germans. Xiaona. She is 33 years of age, ranked 21 in the world. Doubles are about to get underway, with China leading. Two matches to love in the overall gold medal teams event. Blocks quickly.
The whole thing happened very quick at the start of that game, didn't it? And before we knew it, it's 3-0 now for China.
And sometimes it can be a longer break before the doubles, but China seemed to be very keen to get on with things.
Chinese pair, in my opinion, even more prolific is the left-handed right-handed combination. Ding Ning, the left-hander, Liu Shiwen, the right-hander, and with that combination you can cover more of the table with your forehands, providing you move correctly, which I'm sure these two will.
That's what they're looking for, an opportunity for Ding Ning to really unload on that big topspin forehand. It's exactly what you're talking about.
Covering the table with the forehands, and probably two of the best forehands in the world as well. Formidable task for Germany. That's a nice flick. Straight through the back of the ball. Germany open their account. Wry smiles on the face of the German bench there. From Ding Ning. There it goes. Wow. Power Chinese just a little bit too much then for Germany.
And throughout this opening game, it's been very impressive. Eight four, China leading.
Let 8-4. Stop. 9-4.
Worth a try. Got to be positive, got to be brave. You're not going to win by just keeping the ball on the table.
By very quickly for Germany out here. Six game points for Ding and Liu.
Five.
And he saved one. A long climb back in this opening game. They get another one.
Very flat. Shan hits through with a short pimpled serve. You can just see the camera work is so good here. The quality you can see there on her racket, the pimpled surface of her bat.
Let 10-6.
Oh.
11-6.
Beautifully sealed. Liu Shiwen, 11 points to 6. Ding and Liu take the opening game. Tremendous performance from them. Devastating.
They started like a steam train. 6-love before Germany opened their account. Germany did well in the second half of the game. 6-0 down against this quality of player. You really are in trouble.
All going as planned for China at the moment. 11-6, the opening game of this third match. Going to China. Brilliant performance so far from this doubles team. Two matches, the gold medal overall match. Now in this third, they lead by one game to love.
Germany to serve, low ball.
Germany must stay in this match. They must take this match to extend the overall match.
Backhand topspin there, Liu Shiwen. Great angle down that line. Again, Solja doing what she probably has to do. Take on a few risky shots.
The team of Ding and Liu are just so strong. Brilliant in defense and attack. Quick around the table.
Left-handed, right-handed combination, the smash there into the forehand of Ding Ning. Well done, Germany.
We get forehand flashing again from Ding Ning. The performances of China internationally in table tennis and particularly at the Olympics. since joining the Olympic program in 1988, China have won 24 of a possible 28 gold medals.
That is a beautiful flick. And you can see Li Xiaoxia on the bench there. Even she was impressed by that shot.
And if you look at the women's results, it's even more domination from China. Only have 13 of a possible gold medals in the time at the Olympics.
Let 6-1.
So finely tuned. One game to love and 7-1. Ding and Wu leading.
Good topspin down the line from Solja. Counter topspin. Just catching the top of the net, flying off the end of the table. Serve drifted long. Time. Very spinny forehand topspin. And a 6-point lead now for China.
Good attack from Shan.
What the short pimples are very good at, hitting through the topspin. There it goes, into the backhand of Ding Ning. Turn a serve.
Good placement on it. It points the deficit for Germany.
Germany perhaps gaining the momentum here. Still 3 points adrift. China only needs 3 more points, but nevertheless, certainly the German pair rallying here. On the return, out wide to the forehand, Sean.
Ding Ning throwing herself into that forehand. Game points for China. Brilliant performance from China's Liu and Ding Ning. They race through that one, 11-5, lead 2 games to love. It's really not a lot that the Germans seem to be able to do against the quality of play that China are dishing up here. 11-6, 11-5, the score. And they are powering towards what looks like a brilliant gold medal performance here.
I just think the two previous rounds for Germany have been massive wins, and psychologically, they've just not been able to lift themselves. It was always going to be very, very difficult against. We've said how strong the Chinese team are. But I just think mentally, German team have got that silver medal. It's an unbelievable performance, and they've just not been able to raise their game. And that was their only chance. They had to raise the game, play the game of their lives, and still hope for a little bit of luck. Well, it's not happened. It's not over yet.
China in a commanding position. Two matches to love and 2 games to love in this third match. They can take the gold medal by winning this game. Just the focus they are showing out here. So determined. And it's the intensity levels. They don't let off.
Service, the ball just catching the top of the net. Leaning back a little bit there, didn't it? Still, the ball was very close, just caught the top of the net. And you can see, still completely focused, the two Chinese players. So they've lost the ball somewhere in the barriers. Ball is now found, players return to the table. There from Sean underneath the ball. And now it's China with the two serves. Liu Shiwen, Ning Ning will be looking to get in with a strong topspin behind the serve. That was a great return serve by Solja. Kept it tight. Ning Ning had to play over the table, but only pushed the ball.
Three consecutive points for Germany.
Thought very close to being an excellent shot. Another millimetre higher, it would have cleared the net. Shan there changed her mind. She thought she could attack, then she realised it was shorter than she thought. By the time she corrected, it was an error. But she played the right shot tactically. See here, she goes for the hit. Just catches the edge of the table.
One for Germany, desperately trying to stay with the Chinese pair. Game level, 5-all.
Front, 6-5. A nice smile there on the German's face. Can we do it? Puzzled look at each other. Maybe we can.
And the crowd really getting involved here with the chant of China going up. And to encourage the team to seal this.
Been down the line. Liu Shiwen, clenched fist punching the air. They're edging closer and closer to the gold medal.
4 points from it.
Ball just missing from Ning Ning. End.
Good response from Solja. Head level at 8 points all.
Well, pressure there in that rally, but Ding Ning pulls that one out of the bank. It's a great shot by Liu Shiwen. Look at the angle from Ding Ning.
She's fired up, passionate here. 2 points from another gold medal for her. Another for China.
The spin on the ball well there, flipped it straight through the back of the ball. Very spinny backhand topspin from Solja, pushed up the back of the ball.
That brings up the game point for Germany. Take it. The third game going Germany's way, 11 points to 9. China leading 2-1.
I think the smiles on the face of the German players, just they're so relieved to have taken a game. They're trying not to grin too much for the world to see, because the world's watching this final. But I think it's a really good gesture on their part. At least they've not beat. Look, you can see them there, they're delighted. They're even slapping it. It looks like they've won the match. But they've won again. Well done, Germany. They prevented the whitewash.
Great job from Shan and Solja, taking the third game. 2-1. Ding Ning and Liu Shiwen leading, and China leading 2-0. Fourth game about to get underway. Germany nabbing the third, 11 points to 9. China leading 2-1. Germany to serve.
Again, the tactic's good from Solja. She's been aggressive, she's going for her shots. If you play safe against players of this class, you might pick up 1 or 2 points in a whole match. They don't make many mistakes, you have to win the points. Again, unlucky, they're looking to put the Chinese players under pressure. Again, Solja there, being aggressive, the long fast push down the line. But what a backhand response from Liu Shiwen. Just look at that, straight down the line. Shown by surprise, she was going round the backhand side to play a forehand. Too far, staying as close as they can to the table.
Four, two, China leading. They win this game, they take the gold medal. In their lead. Oh.
just the concentration on the face of the Chinese players. So timeout's been called. This is what's been called by G-Shop. For sure she's right. They won the first point and now they find themselves 5-2 down, the momentum quite clearly with the Chinese players. So good call. If they can come back and win 2 or 3 points after the timeout, they're back in the fourth game, and who knows? It's certainly a good performance by Germany. I like the way they're playing tactically. They're actually trying to win the points. And there you can see the reaction after they won the third game. Almost a look of disbelief on their face.
Solja really strikes the ball well, good aggression. But can they sustain it? Good attack. And the timeout paying off at least immediately.
It's quite interesting, I think, that G-Shop's decided she's going to make it fun now for the player. Just go out there, enjoy yourself, go for your shots, and who knows? And they're definitely enjoying themselves, the German players. It's good to see.
We've been enjoying this whole tournament. German women have never won an Olympic table tennis medal before this.
Oh my goodness, well played Germany, and what a great shot from Solja to win the point. As you say, they've never performed really on the world circuit, Olympic circuit, 3 times European champions. Germany, but this is performing on the biggest stage in the world, the Olympic Games. Well done.
There's such high quality out here. China closing in though, they lead 7-4.
Germany spinning the ball, hitting the ball, going for the shots. Chinese players are able to force ahead. Germany hanging on in there.
That is brilliant play. And a timeout being called by China.
Senses that since the last time out, the momentum has clearly changed. Two German girls there going back to their corner, playing really well. They've won some big points. And this third, fourth game is really there for the grabs.
I think what you said about the Germans relaxing and enjoying themselves was evident there. Really striking the ball well, being very aggressive, and within 1 point of the Chinese pair in this fourth game. So interesting stages of this fourth game. China leading in these doubles 2-1. With a slender lead in the fourth, 7-6. The Germans have really been playing some sparkling table tennis.
Second serve in this sequence coming up for Solja. It would be great from Germany's point of view to level it up. Oh, but that's a great backhand down the line from Liu Shiwen. Took it early. Elbow wrist. Didn't just block it down the line, as you see on the replay. Hits it down the line. And you can see the reaction of the Chinese players. They know they're in a battle in this fourth game of the doubles. caught the top of the net from Ding Ning.
Well done to China, the way they are playing here. Four match points, four gold medal points. A little bit over anxious to close that out, perhaps.
Didn't quite close a racket over the top of the ball, so it's one of those gold medal points saved, but three more in the bank for China.
This time they get it. China take the gold medal with victory in this doubles. They seal it. Three matches to love. And what an outstanding performance from China. All three of their players contributing to a stunning victory. They've won every women's team event since it was introduced to the Olympic program. They come in here as the overwhelming favourites and leave with the gold medal. Living up to the expectations. Germany, they have to be congratulated for the way they came through the tournament, already making history, taking the silver medal here at the Olympics.
Just making sure the flag's the right way around, but well done, China. Strong favourite, sometimes that can put a little bit more pressure. Li Xiaoxia potentially playing the last game of her international career, certainly her last Olympics. Bit of pressure on her because of that very fact. They all responded well. Germany, I think, were just a little bit overawed by the situation. They'd given their all in the previous two rounds, beating Japan 3-2, Hong Kong 3-1. It was only in the doubles where things started to happen for Germany, but it was all a little bit too late. And there they are, the best team possibly the world's ever seen. Numbers 1, 2 and 5 in the world. Look at them, they're absolutely delighted. Well done, the Chinese ladies team.
So the result of the doubles, Ning Ning and Liu Shiwen sealing it in four games, 11-7 in the fourth. A very strong victory for them, opening two singles matches, going China's way convincingly, and then wrapping it up with the doubles, taking the gold medal, 3-0.
Thank you. Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs de l'épreuve par équipe femmes de tennis de table.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the women's team table tennis.
Senhoras e senhores, a cerimônia de premiação da competição de equipes feminino de tênis de mesa.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
The medal presentation for the women's team event.
Por favor, deem as boas-vindas às medalhistas.
Tennis tournament has gone to plan for China, starting this event as the overwhelming favourites and powering to the gold medal here.
Les médailles seront remises par Monsieur Timothy Tsun Ting Fok, Hong Kong, Chine, membre du Comité international olympique, accompagné de Monsieur Thomas Weichert, Allemagne, président de la Fédération internationale de tennis de table.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Timothy Tsun Ting Fok, Hong Kong, China, member of the International Olympic Committee, accompanied by Mr. Thomas Weichert, Germany, president of the International Table Tennis Federation.
As medalhas serão entregues pelo senhor Timothy Tsun Ting Fok, Hong Kong, China, membro do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, acompanhado por senhor Thomas Weichert,
recently became the president of the ITTF, took over from Adam Shahara, who'd done a sterling job. Nice smile on his face. Of course, he's going to be presenting the medal to Germany. He's going to be thrilled to be doing that as a German national himself.
Japan.
Japan.
Bronze medal going to Japan.
Kasumi Ishikawa.
And they have been such fun to watch throughout this tournament.
Ito.
There is the youngster Mima Ito, only 15 years of age, the youngest player ever to win a medal in table tennis. An extraordinary moment for her and her teammates, Kasumi Ishikawa and Ai Fukuhara.
Ishikawa, the star performer in that team. They all three played extremely well. Ishikawa, 5 wins out of 5. She's in the middle. Tremendous performance.
They came so close in the semi-final against Germany. It came down to 1 point in the end. Bronze medal to Japan.
Medaille d'argent.
Silver medalist.
Medaille de prata.
L'Allemagne.
Germany.
Alemania.
The German team making history.
Shan Xiaona.
Congratulating the bronze medalists. Until now, German women had never won an Olympic table tennis medal.
Solja.
Great performance from them during this Olympic tournament. And they proudly accept the silver medals.
Different lineup from the German team than we saw in London, but it's a pleasure to see a European team on the podium. Silver medal, well deserved by an outstanding German team.
Petrissa Solja, Han Ying, Shan Xiaona.
And a very proud moment for Thomas Weichert here. Plays table tennis, but not at a high level, just an outstanding administrator who now has the biggest position in international table tennis.
Tremendous achievement for these three women. Silver for Germany.
Gold medalists and Olympic champions.
Medalha de ouro e campeãs olímpicas.
La République Populaire de Chine.
People's Republic of China.
República.
And here they are, the champions. What a lineup. They have to be one of the greatest sporting teams ever. Ding Ning. She is a dual gold medalist from this tournament, winning the singles and now the team. Alongside Ding Ning. Li Xiaoxia and Liu Shiwen. Three outstanding players for their country.
Li Xiaoxia.
And this could be the last time we see Li Xiaoxia, who just received her medal representing China, bowing out of the game.
Very difficult to say anything about those three players except simply the best.
Well, three gold medals and one silver in the collections of Li Xiaoxia and Ding Ning. And for Liu Shiwen, this a first medal, and it is the gold, making her Olympic debut.
She's a bit puzzled as to what the gift is, but it's interesting, the shapes of the gift are from Sugar Mountain.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la République populaire de Chine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas olímpicas.
Well, there they are, the medalists for the women's team. Smiles all round. China, Germany and Japan showing off these beautiful medals that they've all worked so hard to earn here. And the accolades will all go China's way after such an impressive table tennis tournament here at the Olympics. Gold and silver in the women's singles, and now the gold in the women's team event. Outstanding performance from Germany, stepping up on the Olympic stage, take a medal for the first time in the women's event. So a very proud moment for all of these players, more so than Team China, who have excelled here in Rio. Ding Ning, Li Xiaoxia and Liu Shiwen, deserving gold medalists in the women's team event.
So a European team on the podium for the first time. Wonderful to see Li Xiaoxia winning the gold medal. Will we see her on the podium again? Big question. And of course, Japan will host the next Olympic Games. Will they be standing a little bit higher on the podium? Some interesting questions that will be answered in 4 years' time.